Today, I want to talk to you about our belief that AI is one of the most important new paradigms in the energy world, perhaps comparable to the LNG revolution or the breakthrough that we saw with US shale oil and gas, or the stunning rise of renewables that we've seen in recent years. Earlier this month, Sam Altman was speaking before the US Congress, and he said two things that I think are particularly relevant for the conversation today. One is he said that the cost of AI will ultimately converge to the cost of energy. And he also said the abundance of AI will be limited by the abundance of energy. Now, when I first heard Sam Altman speaking about the energy aspects of AI, I have to admit I was a bit skeptical. Sam and other AI luminaries were talking about this idea that energy was going to be such a constraint on AI. The CEO of ARM, microprocessor company, talked about the idea that US power demand, about 20 to 25% of it, could be consumed by data centers by 2030. So I set out on a mission to disprove that, because I didn't think it felt right. I've worked in the energy business a couple of decades. But after doing some substantive work on the space, I think that the neighborhood is roughly correct. So first slide up here on the screen that I've got may help to illustrate this a little bit. So my colleague Mandeep Singh from our technology team at Bloomberg Intelligence, his group has sized the generative AI market. And the takeaway from the chart that you'll see on the left is that by 2030, this is potentially going to be $1 trillion a year market. And so we're seeing hyperscalers, Alphabet, Microsoft, Meta, on down the line, really increasing CapEx. And over the last couple of years, CapEx has more than doubled for most of the players. They're building data centers, and those data centers consume quite a lot of power. So if you take the ideas from this group and translate it into power demand, here's what the figures look like. So if you use 2023 as a baseline, we think, at least in the US, data centers could power demand could surge anywhere from 4x to 10x by 2030. These are profound numbers. Typically, you don't see things moving this quickly in the utility world. This is a slow-moving segment. And perhaps to that point, my colleagues at Bloomberg NEF, they just put out a great new report on this topic as well. Everybody wants to talk about AI these days. And they're closer to the lower end of our projection. Now, why is that? It's because if you do a bottom-up projection and you look in the US, the utilities simply can't get electrons on the grid as fast as these AI companies want to move. And so that leaves us perhaps with the two options. One is that the AI revolution goes global, and I think we're seeing evidence that that's happening. The other is that, you know, maybe the industry will find a way. If you go read about XAI and what they've done with their facility in Memphis, I mean, they're building very quickly there, and they're being very creative about how they achieve that outcome. For those who don't think too much about power, I'll just quickly note that beyond AI, there are lots of other things that are shaping the narrative in that space. In the US right now, and globally, we are seeing a surge in manufacturing spending. This was partly propelled by the IRA, trade policy, all sorts of things are contributing to this. But we are electrifying what we can electrify. So manufacturing, very electricity intensive, vehicles increasingly moving in this direction as well. And so we are increasingly living in a world where we need more electrons. Now, what kind of electrons are getting built? This chart that you see up on the screen is the amalgamation of all of the power plants that want to connect to the grid in the US. Now, the takeaway here is that solar and storage are by far the two biggest types of power that folks are trying to build in the US. It's pretty analogous globally too, by the way. We have about 1 terawatt of solar projects out there in the ether. For reference, the US's total installed power capacity is about 1.25 terawatts. So a lot of solar's out there, a lot of storage, a lot of wind. Of course, there's gas in the mix as well. But when you think about gas, there's a time constraint on the matter. If you want a new gas turbine, well, you have to get in line. If you think about a company like GE Vernova, they're currently taking orders for 2029, 2030. And so there's definitely a gas piece to the story, but because of the pace with which you can move with solar storage these days, we think they are the types of technologies to potentially benefit from this big build out in AI data centers. Quickly, I have a chart up on the screen just showing the solar names. They had a really rough 2024, also a challenging 2023, despite a lot of optimism from the US president and the prior administration. We think they are back to growth in 2025 and future years as well, even with all the discussion about tax policy that's going on in the US. So look for solar names and storage names to be geared to the idea that data centers are rapidly propelling power demand. We think that the hyperscalers, despite their ambitions to be carbon neutral and all of their ESG goals, are a very practical lot. They are focused on rapidly scaling AI, and we don't see how you get there without a significant surge in gas use as well. This is a US-focused chart, but by 2030, we think US gas demand could increase somewhere by 3 to 10 BCF per day by 2030. And this is not the only pillar of the US gas story. LNG demand also growing quickly, as you know, here in this country. And we think that, the sort of playbook is that you see a combination of gas, solar, and storage. Maybe a quick comment on nuclear, because as we saw with the video just leading up to me, CEO of NVIDIA talked about nuclear. Nuclear, great technology. It's certainly carbon-free. And what I'm showing on the chart here is nuclear output from the US, very stable over the last 25 years. And we see this stunning rise of wind plus solar. At the end of the day, nuclear power plants they've all been, behind schedule, over budget. Maybe there's some new technologies, SMRs, that will change that narrative, but good luck getting them built before 2030. I think you have to have a long vision for nuclear. Maybe can play a very significant role in this question as you look out to 2035 and beyond. And then quickly, this is a chart showing data centers in Saudi Arabia. I think we're going to see build out in regions like this. We saw while President Trump was over last week, the Humane announcement. Humane is a 500 megawatt data center. For reference, Saudi Arabia currently has about 165 megawatts installed. So this is a great leap from their current AI data center capacity with continued momentum to build much more. Now, if you want to go deeper on this topic, I'm going to quickly throw up a QR code. Feel free to scan that. You can go read our thoughts on the matter, connect with me on LinkedIn, say hello, and maybe just a parting thought. OpenAI has recently said that when we say please and thank you to the LLMs, it costs the company tens of millions of dollars. That's because of all the compute and energy necessary. So if you want to help alleviate some of the near-term energy constraints, perhaps don't be as polite with the AI. Thank you.